Hello everyone, my name is Kashi Nagar. I am from class 9B. Here is my presentation on the topic Mysterious Temples of India. Today we discuss about one of the most mysterious temple, which is Veerbhadra Temple. The Veerbhadra Temple is in Lipakshi in the Anantapur district of the Indian state of Andhra Pradesh. This is built in the 16th century. The architecture features of the temple are in the Vijayanagar style. This is a view of the Veerbhadra Temple. Now I am going to show some pictures and related information about related topics which is based on Veerbhadra Temple. These are the sculptures of Veerbhadra Temple. Now let's talk about our first topic, Lipakshi Nandi. Lipakshi Nandi Bull is one of the main attractions in Lipakshi and well-known landmark for the tourism of Lipakshi. This is a pictures of Lipakshi Nandi. Our second topic is beautiful architecture. The Veerbhadra Temple is also a notable example of the Vijayanagar architecture style. Our next topic is Kannad inscriptions. Many Kannad inscriptions dating back centuries can be seen on various walls on the whole temple complex. These are some Kannad inscriptions. Sita's footprint. The big footprint seen on the side that is most of the time filled with a little water is supposedly from Sita, the wife of Ram in the Hindu epic Ramayana, while she was kidnapped from Ravan to Lanka. Our next topic is the hanging pillar. Among the 70 stone pillars, there is one that hangs from the ceiling. The base of the pillar barely touches the ground and is possible to pass objects such as thin sheet of paper or a piece of cloth from one side to the other. Our next and last topic is Nagalinga. The Nagalinga sculpture is inside the Veerbhadraveshwara temple at Lipakshi in the Andhra Pradesh. These are the pictures of Nagalinga. This is a view of the back side of the temple. Thank you so much.
Hello everyone, my name is Anjija and I am from Vivekananda Public School. And today I am here to tell you about the Konark Temple. Konark Temple. An architecture marvel of India's heritage, Konark Sun Temple, commonly known as Konark, is situated in the eastern state of Odisha, earlier known as Orissa, India, and is one of the eminent tourist attractions. Konark houses a massive temple dedicated to Sun God. The word Konark is a combination of word Kona and Arka. Kona means corner and Arka means sun. So when it combined, it becomes Sun of Corner. Konark Sun Temple is situated on the northeastern corner of Puri and it is dedicated to Sun God. Downfall. There are various theories about the downfall of this temple. They range from being destroyed by invaders like Kala Pahar or to engineering failure that led to this gradual fall. When it was revegetated in 19th century by James Ferguson, the main temple was a pile of debris from which no main deity was recovered. The Arun Stump, or the main pillar of the temple, was moved to Puri Jagannath Temple in 18th century by Maharaja rulers. What do you see today in the shell of Mahamandapa, filled with sand as Natya Mandap in front? The walls are thankfully preserved for us to admire the sculptures outside. Admire the massive architecture. Konark Sun Temple is a great example of Kalinga Temple architecture on a scale that is really seen. I still wonder how someone imagined a temple as chariot being pulled by seven horses, recreating the iconography of the presiding deity of such a massive scale. Thank you everyone. And the effort.
Hello everyone, I am Dia Gandhi from Vivekananda Public School, and today I am going to present a PPT on the topic Hampi Temple. Hampi. Hampi is a village located near Hoskote town in the Karnataka state, India. The name Hampi can also mean champion. It is located within the ruins of the city of Vijayanagar, the former capital of the Vijayanagar Empire. Vast stretches of stone-spread hills make the backdrop of Hampi unique. Dotted around the hills and valleys are 500-plus monuments. Historical significance of Hampi. Once it was the seat of the mighty Vijayanagar Empire. Hampi's unique landscape and its religious association with Great Ramayana makes it an important destination for local and international tourists and pilgrims. According to Ramayana, Hampi was ruled by the monkey kings Valli and Sugriva. The granite borders of the varying tones of yellow, orange, gray and pink dominate the Hampi's landscape. Distributed either as hills as piles of rocks are said to be flung down by the armies of Valli and Sugriva in a show of strength. Geography. Hampi is situated on the banks of the Tungabhadra River. It is 353 km from Bangalore and 74 km away from Ballari. Hoskote, 13 km away, is the nearest railway head. Mantralayam, which is also on the banks of Tungabhadra in AP, is some 159 km away. Ganesha. The giant statue of Ganesha was carved out of a huge boulder at the northeastern slope of the Himakuta hill. The belly of this statue resembles a Bengal gram in local language. Pratabhirama Temple Complex. This temple, a bit off from the main tourist trail, is notable for its size, and Pratabhirama Temple was known as the Varadhi Devi Amma Pet, the queen of the Tuluva dynasty, king completeness. The Pratabhirama Temple is as large as Vittala Temple Township around the Ayutthaya Raya. Lotus Mahal Complex. Kamal, Lotus Mahal is believed to have been used by female guards of Hampi, and the architecture is based on South India and Mughal styles. Thank you and have a nice day.
Hello, welcome all. I am Sahil Akram from class 9th of Vivekanand Public School. I prepared a PPT on the topic The Mysterious Temple of India. We all know about the rituals and the mystery which is associated with the temples. In India, there are many temples. Each and every temple is associated with the different kind of mystery and religious value. Among all these temples, I choose the Kodungallur Bhagwati Temple, which is also associated with the some mystery.
Kodungallur Bhagwati Temple is a Hindu temple. It is dedicated to the goddess Bhadrakali. The goddess is known also by the name Sri Krumba. The goddess of the temples represents the goddess in her fires, from facing north, featuring eight hands with various attributes. One is holding the head of the demon king Daruka, another a sickle-shaped sword next an anklet, another a bell, among other. The temple is situated in the Kerala state of India in district of Thrissur. Now coming to the history of the temple. The people of Kodungallur believe that this temple was in the olden days a Shiva shrine, and it was Prasuram who installed the murti of Bhadrakali close to one of Shiva. Five Sri Chakras said to have been installed by Adi Shankaracharya are believed to be the main source of the power of this deity. It is also said that the temple was constructed by Cheraman Perumal. Even present day, the Thivya Thandans of 64 Tharas meet at Nilapadu Thara at Kodungallur in the presence of Kodungallur Raja. The Kodungallur Meena Bharani is conducted under this Thivya Thandans. Now coming to the mystery of the temple. This temple is different from the rest temple of India. Here, people of local areas from Kodungallur celebrate Bharani festival, which generally falls in the month of March or April every year. In this festival, devotees abusing and insulting the goddess as in the form of worship. But the very next day, the rituals of purification follows. This makes it different from the rest temple of India. Now, coming to the different things about the temple, that is structure, art and architecture. The temple is situated in the middle of a plot of land about 10 acres, surrounded by banyan and peepal trees, built in typical Kerala style architecture. The western chamber of the inner temple is the seat of Saptamatrikas, who also face north. The idols of Ganpati and Virbhadra are found in the chamber, one facing east and the other facing west respectively. The idol of Bhagavati is about 7 feet high and made up of wood carved from a jackfruit tree. There is also some prominent structure in the context. To the left of the temple sits a small stone structure called the Samadhi of Vyasuri, perhaps a medieval shrine for a deity of smallpox, chickenpox, and other contagious diseases. About 50 meters further is a sacred pond called Puskarini. It is believed that this pond was created by the goddess by striking the ground with her sword. There is several activities happening throughout the day. The temples open at 4 a.m. and close at 8 p.m.